Oh boy, well, people who despise me have some good-ass fuel after this video. Recently, I finished watching all of Tangled the... Rapunzel's Tangled at... Before ever... Look, the series has like 50 different names, so I'm just gonna go with the coolest one. I've recently finished all of Rapunzel's Tangled Adventure, and holy crap, was this show a ride. There's so much lore, character development, and humor in these three seasons. It's nowhere near as good as something like Gravity Falls or Avatar, but what we do have here is truly remarkable. And, of course, it's filled with a bunch of songs that absolutely kick ass. So today, I'm going to be counting down my favorite songs from Rapunzel's Tangled Adventures. Or Tangled series. Just start the damn countdown. One of my favorite episodes from the first season is The Wrath of Ruthless Ruth. Try saying that 5 times fast. Wrath of Ruthless Ruth. Wrath of Ruthless Ruth. And aside from providing a really entertaining mystery, we have this great song to end it all off.
Listen up, if you please. Listen to my melody.
Folks, she wrote every note. So listen up.
Throughout the song, Ruth explains she always had a passion for music, specifically singing, but she always was afraid of what others would think. Eventually, when she got the courage to sing, she literally died of shame.
I let one note come through my throat, and then I died of shame.
Died?
That's actually pretty funny, to be honest. What I like about this song is that it's about not being afraid of what others think and to go through your passion, especially with these lines.
How I yearned to sing it, still I was afraid. Guess I feared they'd call me weird and mock the songs I made. Years and years of doubts and fears.
It's time to heed your heart.
It's also really fun to see all these different characters sing and dance along to Ruth's song. The only reason it ranks at the bottom of this list is really because I think the song lasts a tiny bit too long. It's nearly 3 minutes in length, and I feel like about 30 seconds to a minute could have been cut, but that's really just nitpicking what is a really good song. Kicking off the season 2 premiere, we have this banger. Rapunzel, Eugene, and Cassandra are on a journey to follow mysterious black rocks to wherever they lead, and this song shows how excited they are to explore these new locations. I especially like Rapunzel's verse, with lines like these.
I wanna break every rule and cross every line. All I wanna do is a please and knock the world to its knees and go wherever the breeze is blowing.
After being locked in a tower for 18 years, she finally feels free for the first time in forever.
Cause for the first time in forever.
No! Shut up! Anyways, I really like Rapunzel's verse because it shows growth in her character. She went from a kind of timid girl in Before Ever After to more optimistic and cheerful by the season 2 premiere. I like the other verses as well, but Rapunzel's just stands out to me more. Like Listen Up, however, this song goes on for a tad too long. However, while this song is almost 4 minutes, I feel like this song has a bit more of a reason to be as long as it is, as it has a lot more importance to the story. And as a way to open up season 2, I couldn't ask for any other song.
And the world is waiting.
I feel it waiting.
It's all just waiting up there.
Everywhere, everywhere,
everywhere. I got the wind in my hair and a fire within. Cause there's something beginning. Cause I got the wind in my hair and a gleam in my eyes in an endless horizon.
I don't know if I'm cheating by putting this in, since this song originated from the Before Ever After movie, but the actual series takes place after the events of the movie, and it's the main theme of the show, so I think it counts. Anyways, Wind in My Hair perfectly captures what the series is, and what Rapunzel's character arc is going to be for the first season, and a little bit in season 2, connecting with the outside world. As the main theme of the show, this works beautifully to tell newcomers to both the series and the franchise what they're in for. Lines like these.
Seems like I've spent my whole life hoping, dreaming of things I've never tried. What if one day nothing stood in my way and the world was mine?
Work wonders to show what Rapunzel wants to do now that she feels free for the first time in her life. And I think it's a good time to mention this aspect of the series, because it's the most apparent here and in a song we'll be talking about later on. The animation in this show is simply amazing. The pop-up storybook-esque style of all the characters and the backgrounds are utter eye candy, and they're practically flexing in this song. Overall, Wind in My Hair is just a perfect theme for this series, and it beautifully highlights what newcomers are in store for.
Nothing I couldn't do, not with you by my side.
Season 2 has its finale kick off with this song, showing that the main hero are unsure of what's going to happen after the events of this episode, but they want to make sure that they make the most of whatever time they have left. There's a lot I like about this song. For instance, lines like this.
Maybe tomorrow we'll find to our sorrow, our story has come to an end.
I felt this a lot with my IRL friends and where we'd be heading when school is finally over. It's scary to think of what the future brings, but until then, you should make the most of whatever time you got left. There's also this shot right here that I absolutely love, as it cleverly foreshadows what's going to happen by the end of the special. It also helps that the voice actors for all these characters are amazing singers, and they really nail all the lines that they're given. And I just love how these three stick by each other's side so much. For the most part.
I tried to warn you, Rapunzel. You have to be careful who you trust.
Overall, I love this song. It doesn't stay for too long, it does a good job progressing the story and foreshadowing what's to come, and it's overall just so nice to listen to. Like all the songs on this list.
Without you, by my side.
I got the wind in my hair and a fire within, cause there's something beginning.
Now here's an underrated song that deserves so much more credit. If I Could Take This Moment Back is one of my personal favorite songs from Season 2, as it captures the relationship between Raps and Eugene so well. Although, to be fair, the rest of the series is great at doing that as well. Throughout the song, they both express how much they love each other, and while they aren't ready to marry each other yet, they should have considered each other's feelings before carrying on with the day like nothing happened.
Maybe if I didn't go, maybe things somehow would change, but now I guess we'll never know.
There isn't really much to say with this song. It's really good, but what's good about it is right there. The lyrics are great, the vocals are fantastic, the animation is phenomenal as always. It's overall a great song.
Wish I had that moment back.
Now, for Rapunzel's Tangled Adventures fans watching, you probably noticed there's been a huge lack of Varian. Varian. Protect this child! Varian is my favorite character in the show. Aside from being absolutely adorable, he also has the single best arc in the series, going from an optimistic, bubbly dork to a misunderstood and misguided kid taking down the wrong path to a valuable member of the team. He really is an amazing character, and no song in this series shows that off more than... Varian Ryan is on a journey to the kingdom to find Rapunzel to help him save his dad. There are so many lines that make the song stand out so much.
Just this once, let me come through for you the way that you want me to. And when I return, and I'm more than you dreamt I'd be, maybe then you will realize that you never actually knew me at all.
All Varian wants to do is impress his dad and make him proud, and he wants to do that by going on a huge journey through this ferocious blizzard to save him, and that makes all of the moments after the song just so much harder to watch. And that reprise, just... someone hug this poor child!
They will.
This song is so relatable. I know all too well about trying to do something to the best of your ability, but then being outshined by someone. Hell, so many people could probably relate to this song. Cassandra has always felt like she's always in Rapunzel's shadow, and this song shows what she was struggling through inside. And Rap snapping at her earlier in the episode was finally her breaking point. The reprise is even more heartbreaking as we learn Mother Gothel was Cass's mom and was almost never there for her, and chose Rapunzel over her.
Guess by now I oughta know my place. Do your humble duty with a smile on your face.
I love this song so much because it helps the audience learn so much more about Cass as a character, and the fact nobody but her can hear what she's saying and how she's hurting really helps send the message that she feels like she's talking to herself. In her eyes, she could yell and scream as loud as she could, but no one would ever hear her. People will still think she isn't capable of much and cast her aside in favor of Rapunzel. Overall, I absolutely adore this song for the message it sends and how we get more insight into who Cass is and was.
You'll find me waiting in the wings.
I got the wind in my hair and a fire within, cause there's something beginning.
Similar to Waiting in the Wings, this song shows the insecurities Cass holds inside of her being in the shadow of Rapunzel. Only this time, it isn't a lament, it's a villain song, and one that kicks all kinds of ass.
This has to stop now, whatever it is that you're going through, we'll fix it together, me and you, just like we've always done.
Since Rapunzel is hearing what Cass is going through, she finally feels like someone is actually hearing this. However, this ultimately doesn't matter because throughout the song, Raps isn't really talking to Cassandra, she's talking at Cassandra with lines like this.
So before another line gets crossed and everything we've had is lost, just wait.
This only fuels her anger towards her and pushes her even further away. It makes it a lot harder for both of them to reach each other because they're both doing something wrong. Rapunzel isn't properly communicating with Cassandra and not really listening to her, which causes her to be pushed further and further away. Cassandra isn't properly communicating her feelings. Rather than staying to talk with Rapunzel, she runs away, burns the bridge without hearing the other side, and makes assumptions.
And that line between the beggars and the choosers is the line you never let me quite ignore. You don't know how much I've been denied.
You might be thinking that I sound like I'm complaining a lot and this shouldn't be in the top 3. Well, the thing is, I love that they did this. I love that this is a gray situation. Both sides are right and wrong to some extent, and they justify both characters and how they feel. There was clearly a lot of thought put into how to execute Cass's betrayal, but it's actually really damn impressive. And the song beautifully shows how Cass has had enough of Raps and everyone else pushing her aside. I didn't really talk about the song that much because the context surrounding the song is what makes it so great. I'm of course not saying that the actual song isn't fantastic. I mean, listen to this.
I'm taking what's mine. Every drop, every smidge. If I'm burning a bridge, let it burn.
Seriously, whoever plays Cassandra on the show, you are a goddess at singing. The lyrics are also fantastic, showing just how much Cass has suffered over the years, and how being pushed aside for someone else has hurt her. While I might not be too fond over how quickly she was redeemed in the finale, this song will forever serve as a reminder to why Cass is my second favorite character.
And for us, that's when over the
Cassandra, wait!
I'm crossing the line.
I know I've sunk pretty low, but whatever I've done, you deserve.
Varian,
quiet.
Okay, who's actually surprised us in the top two? Building up to the big fight of the season one finale, Ready As I'll Ever Be perfectly gets everyone watching hyped for what's coming up next. It's no wonder this song got so popular online. I mean, Jesus Christ, this song is everywhere. I actually remember first hearing this song in a Steven Universe AMV back in 2019. I didn't think much of it until I listened to it again in May of last year for one of my plush videos, and I instantly fell in love with the song. There's so much here that I love. For example, I feel like this song serves as a purpose for Varian's character arc at this point of the series. Everyone pretty much left the kid without a pot to piss in, and the one person he actually looked up to for help didn't even bother to show up after the blizzard. So I understand how he's feeling completely. Does he go overboard? Yes, but there's at least an actual consequence he gets. Hint, hint, wink, wink, nudge, nudge! I'm not really talking much about the actual song, because the good things I can say about it have already been said in the other entries. Oh, and also, Jeremy Jordan, the voice actor for Varian, just teach me your ways.
And I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready. Ready as I'll ever be.
Overall, it's no wonder this song is everywhere. The instrumental is awesome, the vocals kick ass, Varian is a really good antagonist, and it's just the perfect build-up for the final battle. I'm ready as I'll ever be to listen to this one a dozen times after this countdown.
Ready as I'll ever be.
I got the wind in my hair and a fire within, cause there's something beginning.
Okay, so I originally wrote this part of the script when I still had the strike from the Lies and Deception video, and I still kind of stand by it because there were like a dozen more songs I could have picked to be on this list. So I'll just choose one and have that represent all of them. Everything I ever thought I knew. That is your honorable mention. I am bad at script writing. Now, I had a very hard time picking a lot of the songs for this countdown, especially near the end. There was a lot of songs to choose from, and so many that absolutely knocked it out of the park. But there is one song I knew from the start was going to make it on top.
Suddenly you lose your way and lose the thread. Lose your cool then lose your head. Every loss is harder to excuse.
Nothing Left to Lose is not only my favorite song from the Tangled series, but I think it might be one of my favorite songs from any piece of media. For one reason, it is literally perfect. I cannot find a single flaw with this song, no matter how many times I've listened to it. The instrumental is sinister and really captures the vibe of trying to talk down a powerful threat you know can't be stopped, but you're still trying anyway. The vocals are mind-blowing. Cass and Varian were already amazing on their own, but together is just Listen to this!
Listen, please, you've lost your grip and lost your mind. All's not lost, don't be so blind. Cut your losses, drop the eye with you.
And of course, the animation is absolutely stunning. Cass's Castle is gloomy, barely any light through it, and it works so well. The expressions and movements from both characters perfectly capture the desperation of Varian and the stubbornness of Cassandra, and they're all so smooth. And of course, I can't talk about the animation in this song without that absolutely jaw-dropping 360 spin the camera does near the end. In a 2D animated show, that is so hard to do. But because this show's characters are 3D puppets, they do this effortlessly. While I wouldn't say the animation in this show is on the same level of amazing as Rise of the TMNT, it is still absolutely beautiful. Overall, if you've learned anything from this video and from this song alone, it's to please watch this show. It may look like a crappy girl show on the outside, but on the inside is actual love, care, and passion that went into the show's spectacular 3 seasons.
Now I have nothing left to lose.